Hey people, it's the Pilgrim, and this is my Tech Enforcer shop. I want it to be like a futuristic scrap dealer's, have that sort of feel. Like it was a place you could come and like build, trade, repair anything that was to do with the mechs or tech. And got little scout things as well, so it was like, yeah, that was sort of the idea behind it. Yeah, built a few of these little computer consoles here, just messing about with artifacts and air conditioners. But it turned out pretty well. Got like a little tombstone with the computer screen on it. What else have we got? Got artifacts dotted about the place. Got just a lot of lighting and colour. Looks pretty good. I painted most of the building with the sky and silver paint, especially on the exterior, just to sort of give it that patchwork look like the building's outside. I had to remove some ceilings above here as well to get the tech replicated in. But there's doors on either side as well, so you can get your flyers straight inside. A few different levels to live on, plenty of room for putting all your production and stuff like that in here. Just a few places just to come and chill out, just look at the scenery, man. I like this, not overly pleased with the rest of the map, but it's decent, it's alright. Over here is another little computer desk, just supposed to be putting the AI into the enforcer there. Looks alright. Got a few tech generators dotted around the place, and a bunch of air conditioners, just keeping all the computers cool. That was the idea for that. And this is like the main shop level, and the cryo fridges, and the gacha. Just been feeding him, collecting the crystals up to see what I got. Don't really know much about them yet, so I'm still sort of experimenting with that. But the cryo fridges, I really think they're going to change things for this game, definitely. Bases are going to be able to be so compact and, you know, and easily defended now. It's going to be great. Plus, if you need to like get your kibble, you can just like break out all your kibble dinosaurs, give them a couple of hours, collect a few eggs, and store them back away again. So you're not going to need like massive sprawling bases, and put most of what your base design into defense, or, you know, finding new areas to build. It'd be really good. The whole base has been built around that in the centre. That little console where you can go and build the enforcers. There's loads of them about, so you're not really blocking anyone off from using it. Plus you can charge them if they want to. This is like the shop area, so this is like the main desk. Got a Gatling gun there, making sure no one screws you. Yeah, this is the little thing where you get all the bits from. But you can build everything in the tech replicator anyway, so don't have to worry about it. These doors shut. I painted them with sky colouring, that's why they're that silver colour. Right, here's the front of the shop. That's a custom sign I made and just used the converter to put it into the game. I know you can't do that on consoles, which you have to paint your home, I suppose, but that's the only thing. The rest of it's all buildable on every platform, really. It's no mods or anything used, just a lot of tech which is hard to get hold of, but you can make it out of metal or whatever. Got a few more enforcers dotted around the place. Got some guns up there to protect the entrance. Yeah, just show you the cryopods. Right, just throw it, pops your dinosaur out. It's cool. Got a pitch black enforcer there, it looks well mean. Yeah, I just really like the way you control these things and the way they move, and it's very similar to a drake, you know, rock drake and stuff, but it's got, look at that, just straight over to you. And then when you want to pack them away, just hold it underneath them or close to them. Hold down left click and you put them straight back in the cryopod. There is a bit of a timer on it, so like if you threw it down again now, it'd have cryo sickness, because you can only throw out so many, you know. I think it gives you like a 200 or 300 second countdown. And there, if you hold the button, and you sort of see like a little blue holographic shape of your enforcer, and wherever you put it, that's where it'll sort of blink to. So that works really well. You see it there, like I was trying to get like a similar sort of shape and design as the city around it, with all the different levels and the sloping sections. That sort of patchwork paint. And I used, like I said before, I used the tech doors to get that sort of blue like line down the side of the buildings, and I painted all them cyan. I don't know if it's a different colour to get a better blue on it. I'll have to try out a few more actually, but it looks good. And then I put a few windows in around the place, just you can block it off if you want it to be safer. That's just let a bit of light in. And there's the roof, did it like all sloped and on different levels and everything. I think it worked, so turned out pretty well. I really enjoyed building this. I've not done much tech stuff really, but yeah, I really do think the cryopods are going to really change base design. Oh, and them two things on the right hand side and the left there, you see outside, then that was just the mounts. Got a couple of Gatling guns there keeping an eye on you customers, put a few more little signs up. Yeah, I just wanted it to have like a really sort of dingy futuristic look, like something out of 2000 AD or Blade Runner, you know, that sort of idea. But yeah, I really thought it captured it quite well. It looks good, I'm happy with it. Yeah, the taxidermy thing outside, you've got a taxidermy tool, and you kill something, you literally go up to it, skin it, and you get the carcass. You just drop that inside the taxidermy mount, and then you've got different ways to pose it and stuff. Looks pretty cool. Yeah, there we go. It's a little tour. We'll get on with the how to build in a minute. These consoles here, I just thought I'd better like step it up a little bit, because I was playing the other day. I was on Facebook, and I was talking to someone called Queen Goddess Gaming. And she showed me a few of her videos, and her sort of decor design she's done just with the vanilla stuff is really, really good. I'll put a link to her channel so you can check it out. It's only a small channel, but she's got some really good ideas. And a guy called The Warrior as well, who I chat to on Facebook now and again, he's got some really, really good builds. He builds like his little miniature skyscrapers and stuff. Another small channel, I think he builds on console. But yeah, I'll put links to their channels in, give them a bit of a shout out. Right guys, this is the how to build, and I'll do the rest of it with text, because I want to get back to the game and I don't want to be chatting all the way through it. So I'll catch you later, have fun building.
We'll be right back.
Right, I'm back. I just wanted to show you this quick. Jumped out my mech and he got sort of stuck hovering above the fences and I couldn't get back in him. And found out that cryopods work on mechs. It's definitely my new favourite tie this. And they don't get cryo sickness either, I don't think. I was wondering whether you could sort of get into someone's base and then just sort of toss that down while you're inside and jump in it and just obliterate the place from inside out, or whether there's you know, they prohibit you from placing it, you know, throwing it down when you're near an enemy structure or something. Someone could test that out in PvP, I'd like to know. Right, and that's it, we're done. That's just a little sort of thermal holographic view from the scout. Not great at controlling these things yet. And that quote on that sign, I'm sure I heard that in a movie once about an AK-47. This guy was saying it, but I can't remember which film it is. Anyway, if you enjoyed the build, check out the rest of the channel. Got loads of builds on there. I get a video out like every, you know, maybe one or two videos a week. It's 90% building stuff. I do a load of how to build videos with no mods and things, so it's all good for console and official, mostly PvE mainly. Yeah, so that's about it. Yeah, if you liked it, sub, comment, hit notification bell, all that sort of stuff. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys.